We're not actors or TV personalities. We're just a couple of guys who want to show you how to restore your car. Sometimes we mess up. Sometimes we consult the pros. It's never a problem. It's always a project.
Coming up on Autorestomod, Jeff gets sweaty legs and uses a laser thermometer, and the guys get into some bondage?
Bonded logic.
Oh, bonded logic. Ooh, got concerned there.
Order a bunch of parts to get ready for the car show this weekend?
And I got a hot deal, too.
You think? Think again.
Oh, man.
Tired of back orders? You need NPD. With four strategically located superstores, orders are shipped direct to your door within 1 to 3 business days. National Parts Depot has quality restoration parts for Ford truck, Mustang, Camaro, Chevelle, and Firebird. For your free catalog, visit NPD online or call toll free.
We're back!
Hey, where you guys been?
No place tropical. To work on your 5-speed.
Oh, how'd that go?
Went really well, man. That's going to be sharp. He did a really nice job, and I think you're going to be real happy with it.
Oh, good.
Cool. So, what's going on? Because it looks like the fair lane has moved.
Yeah. I had to move it a little bit.
Did you do?
No, I just moved it over a little.
I'm going to check the tires on this thing. Hey, we got some new product coming in from the guys at Bonded Logic, and Summit sent it to us.
Oh, nice.
For doing the floor pans on this thing, because I know these are hot. I'm going to take it out for a drive, show the guys exactly how hot a car without any kind of insulation can be. And then we're going to come back and start working on it. So I'm going to go ahead and take this thing and pull it out right now.
Yeah,
and take care of it.
I noticed that when I moved it a little bit. It got a little warm.
You had to have moved it quite a lot for it to get as warm. Yeah,
just a little bit.
All right, get the door, man, okay? Right, so this week we're going to be talking about sound deadener and carpet underlayment. And basically, those are two of the same things. Now, what we're going to be using is a product from the guys at Summit that is a foil and denim product. Now, this is kind of cool because what it'll do is it will give you a nice heat control as well as sound control inside the car. And right now, we need a little of both. The floor pans on the car, as you can see, are very bare. And what we're going to do right now is we're going to go out and show you just how hot the floor pans on one of these cars can get. Now, we've got a 351 Cleveland, and we've got bare floors. And so what we're going to do now is I'm going to give you a baseline, which on the tow board is 77 degrees. Well, 77.8 if you want to get all technical and stuff. And the floor pans, which are 77.6. So that's our base cool line. Now I'm going to go out and take the car for a little bit of a drive and kind of chat about this a little bit, but show you exactly where we're at with what we got. All right, we just left the shop about 5 minutes ago. Our outside ambient temperature is around 76 degrees. And our tow boards now are 115.6 degrees, and our floor pan is 109.7. And now that's give or take a little bit. In other words, you may have a little bit more temperature there. And that's what I'm talking about with this. That pit of heat coming into the interior is gonna be an issue. You're gonna feel it. I can feel it coming up through my blue jeans, and I know the camera guy in our back seat, he can probably feel it coming up through his pants because he's sitting on a bare floor pan. So I know that it's really freaking hot in here. Now, we're not all or nothing people around here. You've got an example of what our temperatures are going to be like in this thing. If I'm honest, I'll use a little bit of everything. We've got some Dynamat product in here. We've got this new product that we're going to be using from the guys at Summit. We're going to use some lizard skin on this car, and we're going to be doing different things in different areas because, quite frankly, they're convenient. And that's what we're looking for, is we're wanting to have a nice setup that's convenient and easy to use in the particular area and application that we're going to be using it in. All right, so we're on our way back to the palatial Ford estate. It's in the low 80s outside right now, so the temperature's come up a little bit, but I can guarantee you right now there is a lot of temperature coming up off these floor pans. It's warm in here, and I don't want it to be warm in here when we're driving. We've got an AC system. We want that to be as efficient as we possibly can, so as soon as I get this thing up here in the yard, we're going to do a couple more temperature taps off the floor pan. So what we got at the tow, right about where the exhaust manifold is, we got 153.9 degrees. That's almost 154 degrees. We'll go back a little bit and tap the floor pan where the pipes are, We're at 123.7 degrees in this car, and that's freaking hot. All that's trapped inside here with us, and if we had the back window on this wagon rolled up, all that heat's just gonna pack in the back of the car and move forward. So, what we wanna do is get rid of the heat. I need to get out of this car right now, man, because my legs are sweaty. And when my legs are sweaty, I'm not happy.
So this is the material that we got. It's made by Bonded Logic. We got it from Summit, and this is their Super Insulator. And as you can see, it's got aluminum on both sides, and the aluminum makes for a really good radiant heat barrier, which is excellent because that's what we're getting off the exhaust system is radiant heat. And wow, not sure if we got enough to do the whole fairlane. That car's about the size of two football fields.
I don't know of any. I think we've got more than enough.
How much did you order?
Too much. We've got enough to do my car, your car, maybe even another car or two.
Cool. Well, let's get past the Fairlane. It's pretty big.
It's not going to take up all this for the Fairlane.
You may have less than you
no.
think.
No. I think probably two sheets of this will be enough. I didn't realize there was this much. And that's something you guys need to be aware of. And what we're going to show you next is basically measuring this stuff out. Because if I'd done a little bit better job of measuring, I wouldn't be sitting on a world supply of the Bonded Logic material. So we're going to show you now how to measure this stuff out. So let's get busy on that.
Cool.
Okay, so now we're going to go in and start working on measuring this thing out so that we could actually get a better idea of how much of this product we need. We know we have too much, but we're going to show you guys how to go in and get a good measurement out of it.
I don't think you have too much. You're getting all four rolls.
It is a big freaking car. I mean, it takes up 3/4 of the garage as it is. And what you'll want to do is you'll want to go to the base of your firewall pad. Now, we've gone in and used some Dynamat Dynaliner on ours, and you want to measure back and keep your tape measure pretty tight to your floor like we're doing here, and go back till you hit 4 feet, which is about right here. Now, we'll know that we can do that and get to the middle of this part of the seat, and then we'll have to take our second section of 4 foot material here, the Bonded Logic stuff, and go on back from there. And I think Vinny's already established that we probably, with two sheets of it, we may have enough going from front to back of the car to make this work.
Yeah, right to where the Dynamat ends. We're right at about 7'8".
Okay, well that'll be about enough then.
So we've got a little wiggle room.
So we got enough with the two sheets that we should be able to do this. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to go in and measure across the chassis this way to make sure we've got enough of the Bonded Logic material. Now you're going to do the same thing. You're going to go down into the valleys here, all the way across the car, drop down the valley on this side, and to the sill plates, we're right at 5, a little bit more than 5 foot. So we should have enough back here. The only place it's gonna get a little sticky is you need to also go and measure up here at the very front of the car on the larger section of this hump to make sure that you got enough material with that. Now what I'm gonna do with this, and we'll show you this in a minute, is I'm gonna go in and cut the actual pieces to match the carpet underlayment that comes in the cars. And then after we get through with doing some other stuff like POR 15 to prevent any rust, we should have this thing good and set up and actually ready for some carpet. All right, now we've got our floor pan cleaned up a little bit. What I'm going to tell you about POR 15 is this. I like using this product in the low-lying areas on any of the floor pans I do in these cars because, quite frankly, if you don't put the POR 15 down and you just leave primer, you can actually develop some rust. Now, we've got some window leaks on this car because the gaskets need to be replaced, but you can see right here, there's a little streak of rust, which tells me that that primer is not doing anything to inhibit a rust situation. What I plan on doing with this car right now is going in and getting the POR 15 and just brushing in all these low-lying areas, even up here onto the tow boards and out over into here, any area that's got the primer on it, because if you don't, you stand a good chance of developing a rust problem. That's what's happened to this car in the past. If you look at this rear floor pan, we had Gary and the guys at Mustang Central do some repair work on the original because it wasn't totally gone. But you can even see just from the car sitting around that there's some rust that's on the floor right now from it just sitting out. So we want to go in, put POR 15 in the back floor pan, in the front floor pan. Okay, now I'm going to go in and start laying this out, but I'm going to give you a few tips. Now, we've gone over this before, but it bears repeating. When you're dealing with the POR 15 product line, do not go in and just pull it straight out of the container unless you plan on using that entire container. What you'll want to do is you'll want to stir it up with some kind of stir stick. Now me, I like to use a screwdriver because it's all reusable. I can wipe it off with a cloth and we're good to go. And then you'll want to go in and pour it into another container like we've done here. Now I like using these kind of plastic containers. They're basically sandwich containers. I like using these because, quite frankly, if the POR 15 sits in them for a little while, you can actually go in and break the POR 15 out of the container and reuse it for something else. I wouldn't recommend putting your sandwich meat back in it, though. I'm going to coat the entire floor pan on this all the way up onto the tow board. And the reason I'm going up to the edge of the tow board with it is if I've got the carpet dropping down to any degree, you might be able to see the gray. If it's black, since our interior is black, it'll just look like part of the carpet. Another thing you might want to do that I'm not doing here, and I probably should, is wear a set of latex gloves when you're putting this stuff on, because the POR 15 will get on you and stay on you for days. One other point I'll make with this is you don't want to spray this stuff too much. I don't like spraying. If you do spray it, use a respirator. You might even want to wear a clean suit with it. If you wear contact lenses, don't wear your contact lenses to spray it. You can actually ruin a set of contact lenses because this stuff likes water and it will adhere to your contact lenses and it won't come off. Don't ask me how I know that. All right, I'm just about done with this side. We'll get both of these done. We're gonna wanna let this stuff sit up for about 24 hours before we do anything else inside the car. Okay, so just exactly how much difference can this product, this super insulator that we got from Summit, make in the interior of your car? Actually, quite a lot. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a measurement. We ran the car for a little while. I'm gonna take a measurement on the floor pan. Right about here is where the exhaust manifolds sit on this car. It's probably cooled down a little bit since before. Now we're at 120 degrees here. I'm gonna measure this. And that's at 74.6. Now, the cool thing is on this is when we were running the engine before, we were up at about 170 degrees on the pan, and we were still down in the 80s on the super insulator. I like this product. It's better than straight jute. And the reason I say that is this. I haven't run across any of these old muscle cars that don't occasionally get an interior leak. With the aluminum base on this product that we've got here and the aluminum top, it's not going to allow the water to soak into the jute. And even if it did, with the flame retardant material that the guys at Bonded Logic put into the denim jute that's in the middle here, it actually has a mold inhibitor in it, so the product is not going to cause a problem for smelling bad. And so with this product, especially if you run it up onto these areas of the car up in here, you're going to end up not really having to worry too much about any kind of water intrusion getting to the product. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take it back inside and using a paper template to set up your floor pans. Okay, so now you wanna put this stuff in the car. Now the one, I don't even really wanna call this a disadvantage, but the one thing you're gonna have to do is you're gonna have to cut it all out yourself. What you can do to make that job somewhat easier is if the car already has underlayment on the carpet, use your underlayment as a guide. Now, I've got an original carpet set for the car we're working on right here, and I've already made a template off of it. The one thing I'll say about modern carpet is this. Usually, you don't have all of these little notches and divots that you have in this particular underlayment on this car. That's not going to be in a lot of your new carpet sets. They're just not going to do that on the modern stuff. Now what I've got here is some paper that we use for just masking off stuff that we get down at the Home Improvement Center. And you'll notice that I've kind of blown holes in this for general position of the seat belts. And I'm going to use this to transfer over to our super insulator that we got from Summit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull this out of the way, take the carpet up, and then I'm going to go in and show you how to set this up and make your templates look really nice. Okay, I've got my insulation here, and I've got my template here. And I'm going to set this up on our base. Now, I'll say this. When I cut this stuff out, I'm not worried so much about this upper edge. I will go to roughly about right here, use a straight edge to run out across it so they get a nice, even cut out of this. I'll probably make these holes a little bigger than they need to be. When you're cutting this stuff out, I don't recommend you use your best upholstery scissors to do it. I got these at the Home Improvement Center. They're just a nice pair of utility scissors, because when you're cutting through the fiber wire, the denim jute, and the aluminum, you're gonna dull out a pair of scissors pretty quickly. So if you get a pair of scissors that are like these, not necessarily stupid over the top nice, but good enough, you don't have to worry about making them look too bad. Okay, now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my straight edge. I'd rather have a little too much than not enough at the top where it goes up underneath the seat. I'm gonna make a mark here and here for my lines there. I'm gonna pull this one straight across. Just wanna pull this over. I'm working on ish here. I'm not trying to be super precise with it because I know that this template is not the greatest shakes for being centered up, but it'll do just fine for what we're doing. Okay, my center line is right there, and I'm going to basically mark where the hole for the seatbelt anchor goes. Now I've got a line that I can base all the rest of these cuts off of. The nice thing about this product, if you can see it, there's just actually the little fiber lines that are in here to reinforce the aluminum foil. These lines are basically all pretty straight. So if you can follow those lines, you can actually set this thing up pretty nice. Now I don't recommend throwing away these small pieces that are gonna be cut out of here. I would hang on to those and use them in areas on the car, because there's going to be places where you've got, you'll want sound and heat insulation, but you're not going to want a huge chunk of it, and this will be a good way to take care of this. Okay, we've got all of our Super Insulator in, and wow, it looks kind of like the Apollo spaceship in here, but this is what you're going to need to do. If you'll notice, we've only really covered areas of heat line. We had a big heat line down through the center of the car, and we've already kind of addressed that. So we came up with the idea of using this aluminum duct tape to set it to the floor, and it seemed to work really nice. And basically, all you'll want to do this is to put the duct tape on the seam area and just lay it into it like so. And that'll cover your seam, and it'll stick it to the floor. Now, it will be loose in the center, but I don't think that's really a problem. All right, with that done, we're gonna go ahead and get our carpet set in here, get the seat back in the car, take it out for a test drive to see exactly how this thing feels now that we'll have carpet and kick panels in here to soak up some sound, and more importantly, some heat. All right, we've been out here running around for about 30 minutes, off and on, stopping every once in a while. So we've been doing typical kind of driving. And what I wanted to do is to show you exactly what you're getting off the floor pans of a car that has this Super Insulator in it. All right, our temperature right now on the floor pan of the car, in one of the hottest spots on the floor pan, is 76.6 degrees. That's pretty good. That's really good, actually. Considering that everything on the other side of that floor pan is probably 170 degrees plus, I'm real happy with that temperature reading. And that's what you're looking for, is really good temperature control off the floor. If you've got low temperatures down here, your air conditioning in these old cars is gonna operate tons better. So, that's what we've got, and that's what's making me most happy. Now next we're gonna be coming back with how to install a rack and pinion in a classic Mustang. Now, the rack and pinion we're installing is going into a 67, but honestly, what we're doing will apply to just about any classic Mustang that you can pull into a garage. That's if we can get the car down here, because it's not a car that we have in-house. It's actually a viewer's car that he's bringing in for us to do for him. So do us a favor. Come back and watch us for that show next week on Autorestomod.